I'm Lydia Lunch, spoken word confrontational performance artist. Not much performance, not much art. That's the way I like it. I started out in 1977 with a band called Teenage Jesus and the Jerks. Kind of an abrasive, you'd call it no wave, but it was my turn. No New York style, rant of angst and hate. Three-piece band, formally began when we had to kick James Chance so he could do his own trip with contortionism. Around New York at that time, there were a lot of bands' life was all screaming out and their personal frustrations, kind of primal therapy, shock therapy, public therapy. But one band didn't seem adequate enough, so at the same time, I started another band, Beirut Slumwords. Teenage Jesus was fast, sharp sound stabs. Beirut Slump was more like a mastodon dying. It was the sound of degeneration, slow death. I had to get someone else to sing because even I couldn't sing that slow, but I could play the tongue that slow. It seemed like that wasn't enough either. I had to, as time went on, disband Teenage Jesus, Beirut Slump, go on to 8-Eyed Spy. Kind of my rock mom career. I was kind of sick of wailing and bailing without really having a book. Kind of wanted to rock out a little. See what that was like. You know, four smelly boys in a van, what could be a better way to spend your life? Thank God. So while 8-Eyed Spy was in session, touring, traveling, having fun, swimming in hotel pools, naked, young boys and girls. I thought I wanted to do an album 7 feet, that was called Queen of Siam. I thought from that kind of mood and atmosphere, maybe a 40s, 50s film noir kind of feeling, I might have to get the man that created the Flintstones music, Billy the Plank. He hated it. He did it. He didn't like it, but he did it. Bob White sort of helped him out. Queen of Siam was never toured because obviously that wasn't going to go on the road with a 50-piece band, an orchestra, or Billy for Plank, who couldn't stand my lyrics, my attitude, my face, my singing. It was okay. It seemed like I still wasn't satisfied somehow, so I started breaking into underground films, literally. Beth and Scott B, Vivian Dick, four or five films on the Lower East Side, all about torture, submission, angst, hate, the usual topics I like to cover, uncover, explore, exploit. Films got kind of tiring after a while, so I thought, well, maybe it's time for another band. 1313 sprung up when I decided to bail out the Lower East Side and move to Los Angeles to live for speedway racing, drag racing. It's the greatest adventure. 1313 and Adulterers Anonymous with Epstein Cervenka would happen around the same time, I guess 1982. I didn't like Ella too much, so about 2 years after that I went to London to hang out with the birthday party. We were kind of a happening band at the time, we were Nick Cave, etc. I did some tours, I did some shows with Roland S. Howard, I recorded a few records with them, birthday party, and I recorded an album, Money, Money, Red. Which, like all my projects, took about 5 years to come out. A long way, but worth it, right? Yeah, I had fun. So after London got burnt out, or shall I say, after I got burnt out in London, I decided maybe back to New York, and I hooked up with Fetus, took him with me. We did a thing with Nick Cave, Mark Alden, the Immaculate Consultant. Four shows, the end. As you can tell, my usual style is to execute an idea, conceive it, execute it, document it, and alleviate it, eliminate it, end it, because perfect it and get it over with. One format does not suit me. Tiring of that, living in London, I started writing in notebooks, filling them up, and decided maybe spoken word confrontational performance art was the way to go. Portable, convenient, spontaneous. You didn't have to support four other freaks' face, and I was sick of babysitting. Also, you could be just more topical. You could talk about what really bugged you. It was easier to deal with the hecklers, of which, obviously, at a show of my nature, there would be many. Multitudes. People with nothing better to do than yell out stupid things that mean nothing. I sort of did the same, but I got paid for it. Slight difference. Spoken word, I started out with more in the story format, but obviously, you can't tell a story when people out of Friday night just want to get drunk and fuck, shoot speed, snort dope, smoke a few joints and pass out. Manifestos came into play. A little harsher, a little more aggressive. I mean, it was my nature to get used to it. I still haven't tired of that. I guess I've been doing that for about 8 years and creating music at the same time. Things that haven't been performed live are much like Stinkfist with Fetus. Spoken Word Records, Our Fathers Who Aren't in Heaven with Hubert Selby, Henry Rollins, my own Spoken Word, Oral Fixation, etc. It teamed up with Richard Curran when Spoken Word seemed just, well, maybe you don't always want to stand in front of the public, doesn't mean you don't want to shove yourself in their face. So we did a couple of films, Right Side of My Brain and Fingered, both dealing with the abuse of, well, the ritual abuse of the feminine species. I wanted to help people understand why women get into repeated relationships where they allow themselves to be abused or where they abuse others. I wanted to sort of help people to understand that it's a ritual, it's a habit, it's a pattern. It's not like you wait, it's not like the battered housewife syndrome. It's not like you wake up and you get battered every day. There's a psychology and a drama behind this, which is what women become addicted to. It's like an addiction to adrenaline. Or it's because they've had a life of nothing but pain, and other than the pain, there's nothingness. And that numbness and the deadness becomes unbearable, so they replace it with pain, because it's the only thing they know. So those films caused a bit of controversy, mainly because they were very personal, and feminists, both male and female, rioted, causing trouble in many places where they played. Tough titty. The truth hurts. A little pain never hurt anybody. So now we're up to kind of modern day times, 1990s County. I'm still on the spoken word rap trap. It's convenient, it's portable, it's harsh, it's to point. No ifs, ands, or buts. Well, big but, I guess. Birth of blood. And does it give me pleasure? No. Does it give me pain? No, but it has to be done. It's a dirty job. I'm the man for the job. Because I don't really see that many people protesting about the ills of society that everyone feels. I sort of feel my job is a relief center for the people that can't take the pressure or the pain anymore and want someone who can articulate, concentrate that pain into a small speech that hopefully the next day, certainly not at the time, will cause relief. Relief because they're not alone. As a matter of fact, everyone's got the same disease, sickness, illness, insanity. It's called life. It's one cure. It's up to you to take the next step. Lydia Lunch, 1990.